Hello, hello, everybody. So things are going to be a little different this week. I forgot to tell Marina that I needed to get face surgery, wisdom teeth removal. Don't worry, nothing intense. Because of terrible, terrible traffic, it's very inconvenient for her to come over on a weekday night to record. And she has a lot of finals this week. So we did something a little different. And Kris and his friend W are actually taking over this episode of the podcast. So we will return next week. Marina and I will return next week. But Kris and W did us a great favor and stepped up and helped us make an episode for this week. Otherwise, I'm currently incapacitated by my wisdom teeth removal, and Marina is super busy with finals. So we wouldn't have been able to put anything else out without them. So big shout out to those guys. Thank you guys so much. Kris also edited this week's podcast. He's just freaking killing it over here. So please enjoy this week's episode. It is Kris and W. Please don't like them more than you like us. Just kidding. It's totally okay if you do. But we will be returning next week. So just fair warning on that. So yeah, so hopefully you guys enjoy this week's episode, and Marina and I will see you guys next week.
How do you start this? I don't actually...
Like this, you ready?
Okay.
Fuck, that was the worst clap of my goddamn
life. It just sounds like a...
Yeah, no, I... That's what we're going with. That's what we're going with.
We're going with that?
We're going. We've already started.
Oh, I don't like this already. I'm
give it a clap then if you're so high and mighty about it.
How's that? Is that a good clap?
It probably was, but through Discord, it was shit.
I mean, it sounds about the same for both sides.
No, mine was actually shit, though.
Oh. Okay.
Welcome to Hot Takes with Hot Cakes, everybody. We are your normal and usual hosts. I am Kris.
I am Dave.
And we're here...
Oh, we have no idea what we're doing.
Yeah, that's... Bro, I don't know how to do this. All right. So, W, Dave.
So my name is Dave / W / David, whatever you would like to call me by.
Yeah, you guys know us by now. What is this, episode 7?
I think it's about 15, but...
15?
Yeah, definitely 15.
Jesus, we've been doing this for so long.
I know, 15 weeks at least.
Hang on. Let me make sure. That feels...
Oh, no, it's not at all 15.
Eight. There are eight of them.
Yeah, so this is 9. Come on. It's close to 15.
Price is right rules, W. I win.
Fuck. Okay, you right.
Do you remember us talking about umbrellas last time, right? And how...
Oh, yeah.
One of us doesn't know how to work them.
Yeah, by one of us, you mean you.
Who knows? Who knows who's who in this podcast anymore, am I right?
You're right. Okay.
All right. So, W.
All right. Yes.
What is your hot take for the week?
My hot take is the fact that a few weeks ago, you made a statement about how you made the statement that "toss me" line in Lord of the Rings was made by Gandalf. When it was actually Gimli saying it to Aragorn, where they're like on the little tower thing, and they're trying to figure out, they're about to jump onto the bridge, and Gimli realizes, hey, I'm a dwarf. I can't jump that far. So he says, toss me. And, you know, Aragorn gives him that, you know, questioning look like, what? You gotta toss me. And you know, they give that, like, you know, really nice look to each other.
Lovingly.
And he's like, and he's like, I understand. So he gets ready to toss Gimli. He's like, don't tell the elf. You know, tosses him over. Yeah, he says, don't tell the elf.
Why does he say that?
Because he has this ongoing rivalry with Legolas. And he doesn't want Legolas to know that he couldn't do something by himself because he's super proud.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, so he Aragorn tosses him onto the bridge to fight off all the Uruk-hai. And then Aragorn jumps on and they start fighting. And then that's the point where Gandalf comes over the ridge with all the Rohirrim riders to save Helm's Deep from destruction.
I'll be honest, W, yes. I've seen all of Lord of the Rings one single time.
I am very disappointed in you. And
I'm honestly surprised that I even managed to say toss me and know it was from Lord of the Rings. Because I definitely did not.
Anyway. I mean, you obviously had to because you said it was Gandalf. So,
well, I was wrong, wasn't I?
Yeah.
Actually, you know what? I'm not going to admit I was wrong unless you give me a high-quality Gandalf impression. You can say one line from him, and it has to be great, and then I will apologize.
Okay.
Hit me. Hey,
fly, you fools.
Amazing. Okay. I'm sorry, yes, W.
Yep. Yep. Okay. Thank you.
I honestly thought it was going to be You Shall Not Pass.
See, I went for the, slightly same scene, but slightly different just because it throw you off, you know?
Yeah. Okay. I get you.
Yeah. Okay. So what is your hot take for this week?
My hot take for this week is that, honestly, it feels like the first time we've ever recorded this podcast. Dude, it's kind of weird, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, maybe it's because, you know, slightly drank too much yesterday, but it definitely is like I've never done this before.
Yeah, agreed. Your voice does sound kind of deeper than usual.
What's that supposed to mean?
It just means your voice sounds deeper than usual. I don't really...
Okay.
That's really all there is to it.
Okay. That's fair.
I also have another hot take.
Okay.
Did you know they're making Among Us VR?
No. Why? Why is there Among Us VR?
I don't. So all they did was release a trailer for it, as far as I know.
Okay.
And like, I can't. It doesn't even look like it's. Oh, I guess it might be from the perspective of someone playing it, but like, there's not a lot of HUD. It's just kind of open map, and it looks really confusing, and they kind of edited the trailer to be like a horror movie.
Well, I mean, it kind of, in a way, is a horror game, distrusting everyone around yourself, but why VR?
I don't know. It kind of looks fun, if I'm being honest.
I mean, stabbing your friends in the back is quite... fun.
Okay, what? So here's a new hot take that I just thought of when you said that. They don't show a single killing animation in the entire trailer.
Yeah, because you have to do it, so they don't want to give it away. They don't know how you're going to kill people.
No, like, you know how in the animations, it's like, oh, he opened his stomach and stabbed him?
I mean, how are you going to do that in VR with your, like...
I don't know, that's what I want to see!
your eyes are just going to look at the ceiling and you see blood spurts because you...
I don't know, maybe it throws you into like a third-person view and you watch him die or some shit. I want to see how... I'm not going to play Amogus VR until I see the Amogus people dying.
Okay, all right. Okay,
that's my hot take. Amogus VR looks fun, and I'm not going to play it.
That's fair. Well, I think that's a good enough kind of segue into our topic of this week.
Okay.
So I would say so. Our topic this week is video games. Specifically, what games we think are overrated or underrated in the mind of the public. I think it's the best way to say that.
It sounds perfectly self-explanatory to me.
Okay.
You know? Okay.
I guess I can go ahead and start.
Yes, please.
So the new Lego Star Wars just came out, right? I think they called it the Skywalker Saga. So it's not necessarily about that game in particular, because I think it was well reviewed. Everyone loves it. But mine's more about
minds over it.
Not gonna lie, OG Star Wars, Lego Star Wars, baller.
Oh yeah.
But this is more about like the Lego games that weren't like that mainstream in my eyes. So like specifically, as we brought up earlier, the Lord of the Rings one.
I didn't even know they made one.
Yeah, my sister and I played the shit out of it when we were younger. But it was super, it was the Lord of the Rings one was like in the transition where they didn't use voices.
Okay.
But they used like excerpts from the movie for some of the scenes.
Oh, I do remember this game.
Yes. And it was just like you still had like that physical comedy. And then you just had that kind of weird discord of the serious like voice line going along with it. And it's like... this is amazing, like, whoa. And then there's some, like, item that you could get at some point where it's literally just, like, a EDM song of, like, Gandalf and, like, the tree ends talking, essentially. Yeah, it was wacky.
Lord of the Rings techno remix?
Yeah, essentially.
I think I found it. Wait, so yeah, should I play it?
Sure, I don't know if they'll be able to hear it, but yeah.
Oh, I'm recording desktop audio, so I should be able to.
Okay.
Oh, my internet might be dying, though.
Oh, no.
That doesn't bode well. We are.
Yeah, if we just...
Oh, I found it. Okay, it's playing. Hang on.
Okay.
A moment of silence for EDM. When he gets super close to the night, he starts boogieing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And it's just like the super impactful scenes. Like it's the scene where Boromir's getting shot with a whole bunch of arrows.
Yeah, he's getting shot with a bunch of random shit. I was gonna bring that up. Yeah, I remember that.
There's a broom, there's a banana. You see the Uruk-hai just like, I'm out of arrows. What do I do now? And just pick up random shit and start shooting it. Oh.
But like with the actual audio from the movie?
Yes, I'm pretty sure it was.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Oh, and it.
I think I might insert a clip from that, like right here.
Yeah, it's just like, to me, it's especially older breed of Lego, especially when they didn't have any voices or anything. I feel like those were like, almost in my mind, like, it's like peak physical comedy because that's all they could use. And it's just like, to me, that was like amazing. And then they started going into like extras from the movies. So it was still good. And then in my mind, we kind of like, especially like the Avengers one, I think it was, or whatever.
Yeah.
That's when it got a little wonky in my mind.
That makes sense.
Because especially with, I think it was the Avengers one, it's like they had so many different characters and they all had, and a lot of them, ones that we know and like, oh, a certain voice actor at this point. Or voice, and it's just like, oh, this is not them.
Do you think they had his name is like Yuri Lowenthal, the guy that plays Spider-Man in the PS4 one?
I don't know.
How old is Lego Marvel? Oh no, it's James Arnold Taylor voices him in Lego Marvel Super Heroes, is what it's called.
Yeah, ours was always super glitchy, so we kind of gave up on playing it.
Oh,
pretty what'd often because
what'd you it's play on it
PS4?
On?
PS4, I believe? PS3? PS4? Okay.
Okay.
Anyways, yeah.
So is your hot take that old Lego games were better?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry to reduce it to one sentence. But
yeah. But, you know, barring the new Star Wars one, which I have not played, so I cannot speak to.
So actual voice acting is undetermined right now, but, like, please don't use just random shit from the movie. I used to, okay, so quick little tangent about the Lego Star Wars games, like the original trilogy. You know those, there are these little, okay, let me restart that. My thoughts got ahead of my mouth. Either way, there used to be these weird robot spider things in Jabba's palace, right? And they jumped out of this hole in the ground, and you could, like, jump on them and ride them or whatever.
Yep.
Me and one of my friends figured out this glitch. Where it's like, if you had a character that could double jump, you'd need to ride one of those and jump back into the hole. And then, like, right before you die, you have to jump off. And then right before you're about to die again, you have to double jump. And then you die, right? You respawn as that spider, like, without anyone riding it. And you just are the little spider guys.
That's pretty awesome.
That game was amazing, and it was filled with stupid glitches like that. The other one I remember is in the cantina, which is like the hub world.
Yeah,
you could build this little truck and drive around in a little truck, and we were fucking around once so hard that like it glitched, and I became the truck, kind of like how you could be the spiders. But the truck was indestructible and couldn't do anything except drive around. So I was stuck forever in the homeworld as an immortal truck.
That's amazing.
It was awesome. We had to reset the game because of that. Like, turn off the Wii and turn it back on.
Oh, that's right. It was on the Wii at that point.
It was. Oh, it was so good.
I remember we played it on the PS2. And we bought, like the... Because they had the prequels, the originals...
Yeah.
And then they did one where they like combined them, but we bought them like separate. We had them separately.
Okay.
And I know if you like bought the combined one, you got a couple extra characters. I think specifically the one was like the little droids that are fighting like Anakin and Obi-Wan's like starfighters. Like they're like the little ones that like look like little bugs that hopped on and try to like laser through their thing.
Oh yeah, you could be those.
Yeah.
That's weird. Aren't they like little four-legged dudes?
Something like that, yeah. And I think they have like wings or something too.
What?
They were weird.
Man, yeah. I wish I could remember what they were called, because you know, everything in Star Wars has a name. I'm sure those have a name.
Oh, yeah. All right. Do you have yourself a game you want to
do? Okay, well, let's start with one that will be controversial. But I think at this point, the Mario Party series is a little bit overrated.
Okay. you want to go into, you know, like, detail for why?
Dude, I could. Well, I was gonna. I was listening for your reaction. It was just like absolute silence.
Like, I don't. I've never really played the like originals, so I've only played the like last two.
Okay.
And I know.
Well, then you'll see my problem with this.
The latest one I enjoyed, but it was just like there's like four maps, and it's like all old ones. It's like okay.
But oh, are you talking about the? Like the one with all the remade stuff or the one right before
it? Yeah. The one with all the remade stuff, not the one before that was like weird dice and all that.
Oh, yeah, like dice blocks, specific dice blocks and stuff.
Yeah.
Which one of those two did you like better?
I would say the newest one just because of all the different mini games were super fun.
Okay, yeah, I completely agree. But I think that's my problem is like the Mario Party right before it, I think is dog shit. It is so bad. Like there's like four maps, like you said.
Yeah.
And none of them are that great. The dice block thing is annoying. The fact that you can get buddies and like just increase your rolls, it's all really weird. And I'm not a big fan of it. But the fact that the game is so empty is what really bothered me about it.
Mm-hmm.
Like there was nowhere near enough stuff to do. They just kind of abandoned it as soon as they released it. So they released this garbage game with no extra maps or anything. And then next you hear about Mario Party, they're like, oh yeah, we're remaking a ton of old stuff that you guys liked. And here it is. And everyone was like, yay, awesome, it's so fun. Which is true.
Yeah, it's like, oh, we have to use the old stuff to make it any good.
Yeah, like...
It's like, what? Okay, yeah, I understand, like, you can, like, do whatever you want. It's just, like,
yeah,
make new shit. Make it cool.
I don't have a problem with them doing, like, a greatest hits game. I wish they would put more effort into a new one. Because it feels like they're just not trying if they're making a greatest hits after a garbage game.
Yeah.
Currently, like, Mario Party hasn't always been overrated. It was super fun up until, in my mind, until the second to most recent one came out. But, like, now that these most recent two are out, I feel like it's definitely overrated because they're not doing anything new. That's kind of a lame hot take, I guess. I've heard that from a million people about, like, oh, they're not innovating enough. Wah, wah, wah.
Okay. I guess, yeah. But I would agree with you. It's like, oh, they're just riding the highs of previous success.
Yeah.
Without making too much, like, innovation.
Okay, here we go. I got an alternate hot take. In case that one's too mild for our viewers' tastes. Okay. I hate Overcooked. Overcooked 1 and Overcooked 2. I hate them both. They're too...
That one hurts.
Oh, God. They make me so mad. Oh, my gosh. You have to juggle so much shit. So many different things. And, like, sometimes the maps move so you can't get to things you need to get to. And by the time you realize, like, you need to get to them, the map is broken and you fall off an edge or something. It's unbelievably stressful. It stresses me out so much. And, like, in games like that, I just kind of want to be like, all right, here's my job. I want to do this job the entire round. But no, that's not possible. You have to actually think, and I can't do that.
I can see your point of view, and with the people that I play with now, it does get quite stressful, and there's lots of finger pointing when you don't do something correctly.
Okay.
But it's, oh.
It feels like that is part of the fun, and I agree. Yeah, I just would rather play other games.
It's like, once you hit that point of understanding what you're supposed to do and how you do it,
yeah.
I feel like it's very rewarding.
Okay.
But getting to that point can be extremely stressful, for sure. I can agree with that.
Let's play, was it Stardew Valley? Multiplayer Stardew Valley. There's no stress in that.
Oh, fuck you. Yeah, there is.
Actually, I guess when you die, it's, like, super fucking annoying.
Yeah.
You lose a ton of shit, and you don't have as much energy the next day, and oh my god.
Yeah. A lot of games, when we had that sort of, like, era of, like, microtransactions going on, with like all the gambling stuff and everything.
Oh yeah, that's still going on, isn't it?
Yeah, but I think
when it was a BB.
The newer Star Wars Battlefront 2
Oh, that whole fiasco.
Battlefront 2 is a multiplayer-based game. They had a niche little story in it, which was pretty all right.
I never finished the story. Sorry, continue.
But then, you know, the main draw to it was the multiplayer. And what they had done originally was made it so, like, all your perks for your characters and everything like that were all done through loot boxes.
Mm-hmm.
So you either had to play a lot to unlock a whole bunch of loot boxes.
Yeah.
So you could, like, get rewards and actually, like, upgrade your characters. Or you could spend a whole bunch of money and just, like, get essentially a whole bunch of good perks from that way. And I mean, and that pissed a lot of people off. It's like, goes into the whole like pay to win type strategy that pretty much everyone hates.
Yeah, you sink more money into it and you get an advantage.
It's like, okay, yeah, I can spend a lot of time, but the ratio of how much loot box you get compared to how much I could just pay and get is like astronomically different.
Yeah.
And that was like one of the few things that was like, yeah, I actually, when I still use Twitter, I actually went and like, you know, Disney, EA is making your children gamble type thing. It's stupid. But there, it actually, I don't know if we made a difference as a people, but there was actually changes made to
That's
it.
That's true. It is fun now.
They started off really poorly because of like the loot box stuff and got shit on because of it.
Yeah.
And then they made changes to it to make it, I would say, better, more accessible for like the average person.
Yeah. The Star Wars one really sticks out in my mind because they did like an AMA on Reddit at one point or something. Was in the...
And what was the famous line?
Pride and accomplishment.
Pride and accomplishment, yeah.
Yeah, so like in the Reddit AMA, hang on, let me pull it up. It is the most downvoted comment in Reddit history. Is EA talking about how they needed to unlock characters like Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader by like paying for them in a game that is already $60. Oh, here we go. This person was all mad. The original post was, seriously, I paid $80 to have Vader locked? So like, you didn't have all the heroes unlocked right away in this game that is a full-price game, plus apparently $20. I don't really know why there was an extra $20. The EA community team commented and said, the intent is to provide players with a sense of pride and accomplishment for unlocking different heroes. As for cost, we selected initial values based upon data from the open beta and other adjustments made to milestone rewards before launch. So, like, I understand having to unlock characters or whatever, right? Like in Smash Bros., you got to unlock the characters. But A, it doesn't take long. Mm-hmm. And B, it's free. You pay the game and you can unlock them for free quickly.
Yeah.
I don't know. Mm-hmm.
And part of me is like, oh, you based it off your closed beta, where I don't know if that's true, but
they
like
definitely did not.
Well, even when you do like I feel like a lot of people that play closed beta, sweat it hard. So it's going to be skewed and, oh, yeah, they're getting a lot more points and everything like that, anyways.
Maybe. That's probably true. But like, I feel like the feedback from the closed beta was probably, don't make us pay for these.
Yeah.
And EA is like, we hear you, and we're going to pretend we don't hear you. That feels like usually EA's model. That feels like a lot of people's models, actually.
I don't know if this is necessarily a hot take, but my opinion is like, I feel like these games should be, you know, reevaluated and kind of talked about a little bit more because, yeah, they got a shit ton of flack in the beginning, and maybe they need a little bit of a kick to get going.
Yeah.
But in the end, they modified their games to be incredibly fun. And get rid of the bad for the most part.
I know in Battlefront 2, at least, I believe all the heroes are unlocked right away now.
Yep.
Right? And like, there's almost,
The abilities you get by playing certain characters a certain amount of times, and you level them up and then get skill points that you spend on your abilities. You just play. You play for fun. You level up your character because there's different classes, you know, you're different heroes. So as you play them more, you unlock more to get better skills, which in my mind is kind of like the natural progression of what most games should be. The like RPG element is what I love, and that's kind of what it is you play something, level up, and then go the skills that you think are cool.
Yeah, you actually get a sense of pride and accomplishment now as your character gets stronger. I got a hot take about From Software games.
Yeah?
Shit's fucking hard.
I don't think that's a hot take, my dude.
I had to look up a Bloodborne guide just to get to the first boss. Like, well, where am I going? I should say
bosses.
I should say with Bloodborne, I wasn't like completely lost, I guess. I had to, the guide I watched kind of taught me how to fight my way to the first boss, but I didn't finish watching the guide before like I was like, okay, I think I can do this. And I ended up at the second boss. Because like he guided you down this path where he was like, okay, open these doors for later. It'll be nice when you die, you can come back this way quicker, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, all right, that makes sense. And so I opened those doors and then I was like, I guess this is the way to go. And I don't feel like stopping playing every couple seconds to watch, like, back up the video or whatever. So I just kept running and I was like, all right, I'll find the boss. I kind of know what he's like. He's a big dragon or whatever. Nah, I found, I think he was a hunter. Just like a corrupted hunter, and he started wailing on me, and I was like, this is, I think I did something wrong. Whose sword is bigger, Cloud's or Sephiroth's? Like well, which would you consider bigger?
Cloud's overall. Okay. Sephiroth has it's longer, but it's very thin. Cloud's, the bunker blade, especially when you combine
Isn't
the other
Buster?
Blades with it. Buster blade, sorry, Buster blade.
You got something wrong about Final Fantasy.
I'm sorry, it's like, I never played 7.
I've never played any of them.
But when you combine all the other blades with it, it makes it a big chonky boy.
Okay. That sounds crazy. I didn't know his blade was like a Lego piece.
In a way, yeah. I mainly remember that from the movie that came out. I'm trying to remember the name. Give
there
me a moment.
A there was a Final Fantasy movie.
There's a couple. Advent Children, yeah.
What? How's that work? Is it live action?
No, it was animated.
There's animated Final
2005.
Fantasy?
2005? I absolutely love Advent Children.
Yeah.
Like one of the first introductions to Final Fantasy growing up, and I absolutely loved it.
So, real quick, I have a question about Advent Children.
Mm-hmm.
Do they come in like a giant box calendar, and like every day you open it and there's a new child? W, come on, you gotta stop being completely silent.
I'm just not gonna respond to that one. I don't know what you said.
This is an audio podcast, what do you mean?
No, they do not come out of goddamn boxes.
They don't come out of advent calendars?
No.
Does chocolate come out of the children? Advent children?
No.
Chocolate doesn't
Jesus.
Come out of them? Oh.
Dude.
I don't really. I'm not gonna cut that out. That's staying in. Yes. It's all staying in. I think the only things getting cut out are the silences that
okay.
Also, I'm throwing my microphone around here. A lot of noise just happened. Oh, okay. So we have Wikipedia pulled up, right?
Yeah.
There's this thing Em and I will do when we're hanging out, like waiting for lunch at some restaurant or something, called Wiki Races. I'm sure you've heard of this.
Yes.
Where you start on like some wiki page. You both start on the same wiki page, and you have to get to a different wiki page by clicking the links.
By clicking the links. Yep.
Oh my god, dude. They're so fun. I love it. It is. Everybody should download Wiki Races on their phone because it is amazing. Do you want to do one real quick?
Let's do like our.
Okay, sorry. I
video game rank like scores and seeing if we agree if the scores or not.
Oh, okay. Let's look up. So, okay, explain the game. Hang on. Cut.
Okay.
Hey, W.
Hey, what?
Do you want to play a game?
Sure, I'll play a game.
All right, let's play a game. What's the game? You're I asked you, but you tell me what the game is.
Oh, wait. I have to tell you what the game is.
Yeah. What game are we playing, W? We're playing a game today.
Okay, so what the game is that we're going to look up some video games through time, and we're going to see what their Metacritic score is, and we're going to say, you know, do we agree with these? Are they overrated? Are they underrated? Is that a good rating? And, you know, just kind of go through a couple here, see how we feel about them. I'm going to, right now I have pulled up the top-rated games on Metacritic, so of all time. So some of these we might just have to skip through because we've never played before, and we can't probably give honest, accurate opinions. But I think I think the top rate is honestly probably the funnest way to go at the beginning.
Okay.
Just to see where things stand.
I pulled up a list a little different than yours. Okay.
Okay.
I searched top video game from each year.
Oh,
and
I like that.
This is a list of the best video game from each year, and I'm gonna have you say whether you agree or disagree, and whether you think it's overrated or not.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, you mind if I
go first?
Okay. So, the top-rated game on Metacritic of all time on any platform.
Okay.
It's Legends of Zelda Ocarina of Time with a 99.
Ocarina of Time with a 99. Okay. So, is this just based solely off of, like, how the game plays and, like, the game itself? Or is it, like, influence on gaming as well?
I don't know what Metacritic scores entail.
Okay. Because I don't know if this is a list of, like top scores or, like, opinions on best games. Because the list I have pulled up is, like, opinions.
Well, I mean, this is like the critic score, so it technically is opinions of what they think.
Okay. Well,
I clicked on it. So this one seems a little. So the very first critic score at the top of this one, I clicked on it.
Yeah.
It's 100.
Yeah.
Slightly flawed masterpiece, but a masterpiece nonetheless.
I have a bone to pick with Metacritic and games that came out before Metacritic was a thing.
Yeah. So I think that part of it is this one's old. So it has all the nostalgia and everything.
I don't know if I would count onto it. I don't know if I would say it should be the top game of ever, but I think it is definitely.
The user score is a 9.1.
I don't think it's overrated to put it at the top of that list. I think Ocarina of Time is amazing. I've only played it once or twice, but like the idea behind it, like the concept for the story, amazing. It's a classic Legend of Zelda game, so the gameplay, also amazing. I think it's rated perfectly fine where it is.
Okay, I can agree with that.
I don't know if I agree or disagree with it being the best game ever, but I can see why people think it is.
Okay, so number two, this one's kind of interesting in my eyes. So okay. It's Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2.
Oh, God, I never played it, but everyone I've ever talked to who's played it loves it.
Okay, but get this. Meta score is 98.
Okay.
The user score is a 7.4.
Really?
Yeah.
Wild. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know why that is. Have you ever played Tony Hawk?
No, I've never played Tony Hawk game, no.
Oh, God, we might have to skip the second one on this list. The number two game of all time. Neither of us have played.
But I think this is another one that was released before, so there's definitely that. And looking at the user reviews, there's some of them like, should this be rated as number two of all time? I don't think so. Okay, so like, it's like people
are
who are shitting on the critics essentially and taking the game down. Yeah, so it's kind of like a review bomb.
I feel like any game on this list that came out before Metacritic existed, people are going to be judging it based off of more than just what the game has. They're going to be judging it based on like the history of what the game did after it came out.
Yeah.
Which like does not feel fair.
Okay, let's see if I can find a game that I know we've probably both played.
I will continue to rate whatever the game is, regardless of whether it came out before or after Metacritic. I will keep deciding whether they're over or underrated.
Yes, this one you might actually. Super Mario Galaxy. Metacritic score of 97. User score of 9.1.
I actually played it for the first time on Mario, like the collection of Mario games.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I actually played it for the first time on Switch. I know it's like hugely influential, and it's so like I from what I've played of it and like growing up when it was released, I think it's rated fairly.
Okay.
But in my opinion, it might be a little overrated.
But Super Mario Galaxy 2, same exact score.
Never right even below it. Never touched it. I'm going to...
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. This one, maybe. Red Dead Redemption 2.
Red Dead Redemption 2,
97 from the critics, 8.1 from the user scores. So there's actually two Red Dead Redemptions 2 because they did different... platforms, so let me see what they scored. The one for PS4. 97 and 8.6, so very similar.
Overrated. I would say it's overrated. I played the entire game, beat it. Definitely think it's overrated.
I'm actually playing through it right now, so yeah. I very much enjoy it.
Yeah.
Do I think it's a high 90? I don't think so. I think it's a little overrated. I remember the hype going into it. Everyone, like when it came out, everyone was like,
yeah,
just drooling over it. I mean, there's a lot of, it's mainly about the horseback riding, but it gets really wonky sometimes, it feels.
Yeah.
And it's just like, yeah, it is a great game. I will not take it away from it. It's an amazing game. But to give it a near perfect score, like I'm more with a user of 8.1. I think that's fair.
I didn't really like how slow it felt sometimes. Not the story, but like the gameplay. Like you'd get locked into animations.
Yeah.
Or like you like it's like a classic Rockstar game where like you get conked on the head enough in GTA and you just kind of wobble for a long time before you can control your character again.
So speaking of Rockstar games, let's okay. Come to the next one on the list.
If the next one's GTA 5, I'm saying way overrated.
Yes, GTA 5.
Way overrated.
Metacritic score of 97. Insane. User scores ranging from 7.8 to 8.3. Because they have the multiple.
Gotcha, yeah.
Platforms.
I love the game, and it's really fun to play. Definitely don't think it's warrants the game. Lifetime this game has had.
Yes, agreed. I mean, I don't think it's on my list.
This game and yet, Skyrim both needed to Skyrim, die like yeah. 6 years ago.
I can fully agree. Grand Theft Auto 5, 2013.
Yeah, it's almost been 10 years since that game came out. We were sophomores in high school, W.
Oh my god.
I know. Yeah. Yeah, screw that. The game is
one that I might that I might be able to agree with.
Oh, okay.
Breath of the Wild, 97, user score of 8.7.
I think this one is rated perfectly fairly where it is.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing. I absolutely love the game. Yep, was like such a. I know a lot of people say it's like not really like a Legend of Zelda game fully, but I absolutely loved it. It was. Just like the perfect amount of exploration, like free roaming, you could do anything you wanted,
mm-hmm.
and it was just to me, it was just beautiful and amazing.
Yeah, it was open ended in the most perfect way, I think. To like, yeah. like where there would be challenges if you went to like a harder part of the world, but if you were creative enough, you could overcome the challenges just like without good gear, you know. And it's also gorgeous.
Okay, next one. This one I haven't played, but I've seen a lot
okay.
of play of it. Yeah. A lot of speedrunning. Super Mario Odyssey, 97 and an 8.9.
Oh, so fun. I would say it's rated perfectly fine where it is. I played it. I beat it.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm down with that. Absolutely.
I actually played it co-op with my sister.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is one person can play as the hat. Sorry. Continue.
Yes. This one's more just for me. I've just kind of been scrolling through. There's a lot of, like, really old games on here.
Yeah, that's
like,
fine. You can curate your list however you want.
Yeah. Uncharted 2, Among Thieves, 96 and an 8.8.
Oh, interesting. I love Tom Holland.
Mm-hmm. If we disjoint that movie from actually being related at all to the game stories, well, fine. But if you were saying, hey, it's based off the games... We're not okay. That's all I'm saying.
I mean, to be fair, W, it is called Uncharted.
Yes.
The movie is called Uncharted, and there mm-hmm. is a Nathan Drake in the movie.
Mm-hmm. And a Chloe.
There you go.
But, yeah. I haven't seen it yet, but everything I've seen is like, if you think it's going to be like the game, like related to the games at all, you're in for a bad treat. If you just take it as like an action game or action movie, just for not related at all,
yes.
it's pretty good. It's pretty all right.
I think it looks generic. That's my only, mm-hmm. that's my take on the movie.
Apparently they had some really good scenes where they made it seem like you're like playing the game, like the cool. movements they did and everything and the shots that they did made it seem like, you know, like some gameplay stuff.
Yeah.
But other than that, it had like no relation.
Oh, weird. All right. What do you think of the game?
This one, absolutely love this one.
Yeah.
This one, I will say I am an Uncharted fanboy.
Okay.
I absolutely love them. But I think this one was definitely really good. The first one was kind of like they dipped their toes into it. It was kind of, in my eyes, like kind of clunky the way it was done.
Yeah.
But like this one, chef's kiss. Like, I mean, like the opening scene is you're essentially like
trying to climb your way up through a fucking train that's falling off a cliff. Like, it was just action-packed from the beginning.
Okay.
And, like, their story with it, he's like, you're unraveling his past as you're playing through, like, you know, like the just the main story of you trying to get to the, you know,
the temple.
Yeah, the temple. I don't know, I think this was a temple or not, Shambhala for this one, yeah. We went to the Himalayas.
Oh, so, yeah, okay.
Temple's probably right. It's like, you get, like, the, like, their villains are, just, in my eyes, like, super juicy, like, they're super well played out and everything. Yeah. They're not dumb villains, you know?
Okay.
They're, like, they think things out, they have all the manpower and everything. It's just, you know, you can climb rock around them.
You can what?
Climb the rocks around them so they can't see you.
I thought you were talking about how they were written, and I was like, that's the strangest phrase I've ever heard.
No, that's just...
it's like, what does that mean? Climb the rock around them.
But yeah, I think I very much enjoy it.
Okay. I like it. I've never touched it.
Ooh, Elden Ring's already on this list.
Really? Never played it, but it's a massive game right now, and I've heard it's great.
7.9 user score, but 96...
Honestly, a 7.9 is not even that bad.
7.5 for the Xbox version.
Wow.
Okay. So there's some. Let's go through some of yours that you have now.
All right. Let's start in 2000. I have a list of 20 games here.
Okay. Let's take one for each year
from 2000 to 2020.
Okay.
Oh, I almost said 20,000.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Diablo 2 is the number one game of 2000. What do you think?
Oh, never played it, so I can't speak to it honestly. I know they remastered Diablo 2. It, and I haven't touched it.
It's
so
very
fun. I can't speak. Okay. What is the rating?
There's no rating. This is like an opinion list of the best game of each year.
Oh, the best games of each year. I don't remember my games from 2000 very well. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater came out then.
Oh, really?
That's
kind of a tough head-to-head, because Diablo 2 is, like, that's a game people still play to this day. Yeah. I mean, so is Tony Hawk, obviously.
Yeah.
Those are both good picks. So don't know anything about that one. We'll chalk it up to good for you, Watch Mojo. That's the website I'm using.
Okay.
2001, you're going to like this one. Halo Combat Evolved.
I was going to say, yeah, I saw that one coming.
Yeah.
I haven't played the first one, but the Halos I played, I've enjoyed them. Okay. I've always been a PlayStation Andy, so...
I think...
Never really been on the Xbox train.
I think the first three Halos, like Halo 1 through 3, masterpieces. And also Reach. Reach is great.
I very much enjoy them. The main experience I have with them was like going over to a friend's house, and we would just do like the custom game modes, and essentially just like rockets and super jump.
Oh god, so fun! We'd do that at like Mavericks.
Yeah. So, that's my own experience with Halo. So,
I would say the original Halo Combat Evolved, definitely deserves the top spot for that year, I think.
Okay.
It's a pivotal, historic game, honestly.
Yep.
2002, Grand Theft Auto Vice City. I've never played this one.
I have not either. All right,
we're skipping it.
I was going to say, since it led to the likes of GTA 5 and it surviving for way too long, I do not like it.
I think I just don't like GTA 5 because I'm pretty sure Vice City is a good game.
It probably definitely could be.
Yeah. Okay. 2003. I think you know this one. Star Wars: Knights of the Old Republic. You ever play that one?
Oh, KOTOR.
Yeah.
Yes. I am down for that. They're remaking it, I believe. Remastering it. Remaking. I think they're remaking.
I think it's already out, isn't it? Maybe.
Oh,
I have no idea. So far, I've played two games on this list, and we're 3 years in.
KOTOR is one that go back to quite a bit.
Yeah.
It's set for a 2023 launch.
Okay. So this is a Star Wars game set before the prequels, correct?
Yes. Okay. Handles like Revan. It's the big one. He's a big baggy, which people like. A lot of people. he's a Sith Lord from that time.
Oh, okay.
And a lot of people want to see like them continue like his story and stuff like that, because they have, like, especially with the extended universe stuff that they had for it.
Yeah,
they like really got into deep about like what type of people they were. I'm not the expert to speak on that. I have a friend who's really into Revan and I've got his master that he ended up killing.
Real quick Star Wars side question here. Is this before the Sith did the rule of two thing?
Where I believe so. I think this is around the time they almost started it. I could be wrong.
Okay, okay. Because I think Darth Plagueis helped start that somehow. I can't remember.
Yes. Yeah.
Anyway.
But yeah. It was like a unique one because it kind of used like D&D mechanics. Like when you... It was always in the background, but when you attacked, they're like essentially like rolling like d20s to see if you hit and things like that.
Okay.
And it was like when you like leveled up your character stats, it was essentially like a D&D thing. Like, oh, I just hit level 17 in this stat, so now I get a +2 or whatever, +3.
Oh, that sounds fun.
Like when on rolls and stuff. Yeah.
Sounds very fun.
It is quite fun. It is very long. There's a port on your for the phone for the apps now that you can play.
Wait, KOTOR is on phones?
Yeah, you can play it on your phone now.
What the fuck? I'm downloading it. Okay, anyways.
You have to pay for it.
Next.
Okay.
2004's game, World of Warcraft.
Can't speak to it.
Neither can I.
I know it's...
Oh, you can speak to the next one, though. 2005.
Okay.
Resident Evil 4.
Fun fact, it was like... It had been slightly when I moved to our new house in fifth grade.
Yeah,
my parents started acting, letting us play our PS2.
Yeah.
During normal human hours instead of just winter in the basement where we wouldn't go downstairs because the basement was so cold. but this was we would rent games from the library, actually.
Okay.
And this was one of them, and it was just like my sister and I were still kind of new to gaming. We could not play this game at all.
Was it too scary or too hard?
Too hard for us, because it was it was instilled in the times where you, in the Resident Evil games, you couldn't move and shoot when you're aiming, you were stationary.
Oh.
And we were just not good at the turning and the aiming and shooting and everything.
Holy cow. Okay.
But I have been playing the remaster on my Oculus Quest for VR.
Yeah.
Chef's kiss.
God, it is. The future's awesome.
So
isn't
much
it?
Fun. Yeah. And it's like you can have. It's just amazing because you can run and gun. You're like and it's just
that's really
I enjoy it a lot. Like the knife they give you is hilariously big, just so you know where you can actually swipe.
Yeah,
it's like a blow up knife, balloon knife. That's what it looks like.
But oh my gosh,
it's so much fun. And it's like for your you have your pistols and everything. You have a laser sight, so you can aim better.
Yeah.
And then for the shotgun and everything like that, if you don't hold it with two guns, it has the massive recoil where it kicks behind your head. So you have to pull it back to actually aim again.
Dude, you're getting a lot of Discord messages. What's going on?
Okay, I muted it. Don't worry about it.
Sorry, I didn't mean to call you out.
Oh, no, it's fine. It's a server I'm in where it's you play it's a Discord RPG game.
Oh, what? Okay.
Side tangent. Yeah.
That sounds rad. Yeah. Anyways.
It's in... I'll talk about it later. Okay. But yeah.
Oh, are you
Resident Evil 4, real fun, super scary as a child, and too hard to play. But all now, right. Super fun.
I'm going to skip some because I don't feel like going through this whole fucking list.
Okay, yeah. Hit ones that you think pop out.
Okay. Minecraft 2009.
Obviously.
Oh, yeah. Amazing.
Amazing. Has revolutionized, and it's still popping off.
This is a game I don't think needs to die.
Yeah, I know we say, GTA needs to die and everything. Minecraft can live forever.
Yeah, they keep it fresh. It's so open-ended that, you don't run out of stuff to do. You don't have to pay to get money. You don't need shark cards.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Speedruns of it, amazing.
Speedruns, awesome. Hot take. Speedruns are fun to watch. There you go.
Yes,
that's our hot take for hotcakes.
Yes, okay.
Borderlands 2, 2012.
Yeah, you can agree with that. Borderlands 2 was
I love
peak
Borderlands
of
2.
Peak.
Yeah. Oh, here's a good one, W.
Okay.
Here, I'll make you guess it. Guess what the top game of 2011 is.
2011?
2011.
Skyrim.
Yep. 11-11-11. Skyrim.
Oh, God, that thing's... was it 11 years old?
Yeah, 11-11-11 is 11 years old.
And the sad Almost thing is, occasionally, I go back to it occasionally because I'm like...
I do, too. It is fun.
But I shouldn't be able to play it on my fridge.
This isn't one we said needed to die earlier, is it? I might have mentioned it.
You did.
I take it back. It's kind of fun.
I would love to move on to the next Elder Scrolls.
I would like an Elder Scrolls 6. Elder Scrolls
Online, I think, I've seen it played. It started off bad. I know that. And then the expansions made it pretty good. But it's time to move on. Like,
I honestly don't like how most MMOs play. So I didn't like it.
That's fair.
Anyways. Okay. Give me a year. This will be the last one. Give me a year.
Let's do 16.
16. Oh, this is a good one. You played the shit out of this. I did too. Can you guess? 16 was that our freshman year of college? Freshman?
Yes.
Yeah. What did you play a lot freshman year of college?
Played a lot of League of Legends.
Okay.
Played a lot of Destiny.
Okay. Neither of those are it. Destiny's not even on this list.
I'm good. They came out when they're released, they're shit.
Oh yeah.
When you get all your DLC, it's pretty alright.
Okay. What else did you play? It was a team shooter.
Apex Legends.
Nope.
No.
Apex that was came out later.
Yeah, I was gonna say that's 2018.
Also not on the list.
18. Yeah. Team shooter. Why can't I think of it?
Team shooter. Oh, it's a tough one. Because I don't know. It's Overwatch.
Overwatch. I literally was on the hair as soon as before you even said it, I was it's Overwatch.
Yeah, Overwatch 2016.
Okay, dude, that thing has fallen to oblivion.
I mean, yeah,
Overwatch has.
It had a lot of problems. So did the company.
Yeah, and they've shot themselves in the foot constantly.
Yeah.
And then they announced Overwatch 2, and was like, nothing. Well,
yeah, we'll just play Overwatch once more, like, actually.
I have it on my computer, yeah. Let's play it.
Do you think
we started back up, like, beginning of last year to mid last year, we started playing it again.
Okay. So do you think it's worth the top game of 2016 spot?
At the time, yes.
Okay.
Like, well, look, if we compare it to now, hell no. But at the time, I think it was the game.
Yeah.
For sure.
I would agree.
But yeah. With the blunders they've made with their marketing for it, trying to do like a esports and then
pandering
humbling with that, and then going, oh, we're going to do Overwatch 2, nothing carries over, and they're smaller teams, so everyone who's trying to do esports or Overwatch kind of got fucked.
Yeah. Also, we're going to make our devs crunch a lot. We're going to pander to the Chinese government.
Yep.
Yeah. That's it.
But anyways, yeah.
They took out Tracer's little pose where you could see her butt or whatever. Do you remember that?
Yeah. Okay. But, yeah, I think do you have any, I guess at this point, do you have any, like, closing words about video games, any hot takes about stuff coming out that, people are excited for that you're not, or maybe that people aren't excited for that you are?
Dude, I don't even know what's coming out. I just play random shit. I've been playing Spellbreak.
Yeah.
Which is dead. That is a dead game.
I've been playing Hades again. I absolutely love Hades.
Oh, I did play a lot of Risk of Rain 2 yesterday.
Okay.
I love that game. That is my hot take. That is one of my top games.
Dude, it is pretty good.
I love it.
I will eventually get back into it.
You should, because the DLC for it is out, and I like playing as the Void Fiend and the Rail Gunner. I have not gotten the skin for either of them yet, and that's what I've been trying to do forever, and I probably will after this. So let's wrap this shit up. I gotta edit a podcast, and then I gotta get a skin for the Rail Gunner.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I We appreciate you all listening to us.
Yeah, another successful episode from the boys.
We've been doing this for a lot longer than I thought now that I've looked at how long my Discord call has been going on for.
It looks like an hour and 40 minutes is on the recording right now. But
yeah, so this call's been going on for like 2 hours.
I'm probably going to cut down a decent amount of it, though, because I worry that some of the stuff we talked about got a little, like, drawn out.
Oh, for sure. I rambled a lot, but
yeah, me too.
How do we end this with the catchphrases?
What are the catchphrases? I can't remember.
You're the resident bicon on the Ace of Hearts.
I don't think we did do that.
We didn't start with that, so I think we need to end with it, right?
Well, I think since we're pretending that we've been doing every episode, we should come up with like a fake sign off. Like we say every time. Goodbye.
Let's think of one real quick.
I hope you enjoyed the episode, and like we say every time, W, all right, say it with me. Good. You're not saying it.
Good.
Good evening.
San Diego.
There you go. Good evening, San Diego.
Is that what we're going to do?
Well, we already did it.
Oh.
That was it.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Goodbye, everybody.